Thank you. You know, I have so little new to say here this evening, but there's so many things that have been said, so many things that have been said over and over again. So many things that have been said that need to be said. That need to be said. That need to be said again and again. Again and again. It's too small a planet. It grows smaller all the time. It grows smaller all the time. It's too small a planet. It grows smaller all the time in terms of travel time. We are becoming one family. We share each other's technology and culture and poetry and philosophy. And we have to begin to think of ourselves as a family. We have to begin to think of ourselves as a family. To enjoy the differences in the human family, like we enjoy the differences in a garden of flowers. We are becoming one family. Thank you. We have to begin to enjoy the differences in the human family. There's a race on, and the real ideological conflict is between those who universalists who want to think in terms of mankind, and those reversions to barbarity and tribalism who are still hung up in ancient, anachronistic hatreds, like we see in Ulster, like we can see in Israel, Palestine, that we can see in so many parts of the world. Without some system of world law, we're lost. And we can't have a system of law without a sense of community. And we can't have a sense of community without the underpinning of recognition of ourselves. As parts of one family. We are becoming one family. We have to begin to enjoy the differences in the human family. There's very little time left to muster this broader vision against the ancient conditioned reflexes and psychoses of mankind and his homicidal tendencies. but either we learn to live together or we die together. And is it necessary? Is it necessary? Is it necessary? Is it necessary to have to repeat? Is it necessary? Is it necessary? After 2,000 years, all the things you people read in Sunday school, how absent-minded, how forgetful.
Come on.